So to our invited resource speaker, Dr. Jenny Lind Imaco from, she came all the way from Sibinan. And she's also the director of the Office of Strategic Partnerships of Sibinan University and also Marie Curie Alumni Association country representative. And would also like to thank Ms. Mary Sherilyn Akia. Palapa. She's from the Bureau of International Trade Relations, and we will be relying on her to tell us also about other funding opportunities. So we'd like to welcome representatives and colleagues from the PASCN member institutions, partners from the academe, colleagues from IBAM agencies, fellow workers, and friends. So I'd like to welcome you to PIBS. This is going to be a very informal working session. We are thankful to our resource persons as they will share some relevant information about some research funding opportunities, which can possibly lead to future collaboration activities among and between PASCN member institutions, IBAM agencies, and other academic institutions. Some of you might know that one of the thrusts of PIBS right now is really to develop partnerships with organizations, research institutions, academic institutions, and government agencies in the Philippines. But we'd also like to develop partnerships with other institutions abroad, because we think that that's one way to be able to enhance our expertise, to be able to build capacities. And so we really want to pursue partnerships with institutions outside the Philippines. But for any organizations, especially true for government institutions, one of the hurdles in implementing research projects is the lack of funding and the need for capacity building. So I think kaya lahat tayo nandito is we want to do a lot of research, but given the limited funding that we have within our institutions, we'd like to see whether there would be other funding opportunities. So according to APEC Secretariat Executive Director Ambassador Mohammed Noor, in a speech delivered at the Rajaratnam School of International Studies in Singapore, capacity building is a crucial tool to help developing economies boost trade and therefore generate jobs and development. Research by the World Bank shows that one additional dollar spent on aid for trade in the areas of trade policy and regulatory reform could generate about $2,300 in increased trade in APEC. So, ang laki ng returns. So we hope that you will find this workshop very useful, and so we encourage everyone to take active to actively participate and share your ideas during the Q&A. So let's find opportunities to collaborate and work together. Francis, who's our head of our PASCN, we're developing a research agenda, and so we hope that through this partnership, we'll really be able to work towards coming up with a research agenda, and with each partner institution working on a specific area. Sabi nga namin, we're thinking, okay, we, PASCN Secretariat, did not have to do this, because I'm sure many of you have access to your own funding sources, and you could be doing whatever interests you. But we thought that if we course it through PASCN, we might be able to work on a particular research agenda so that the studies could be, are somehow linked and integrated, and we come up with addressing important policy questions. So again, thank you for coming, and we're looking forward to working.